Hey guys, before I get started, there's just a couple things I want to mention. Number one is, yes, I do have acne scars.
Video light tends to wash out the skin on camera, so I turn them down for you to see my skin better.
And the second thing that I want to mention is that you cannot completely hide texture on the skin, whether it's pitted acne scars, pimples, bumps on the skin texture. You cannot hide it with makeup. Especially with certain lighting, it makes it appear worse. So I just want to get that out of the way and not get your hopes up that I'm going to give you some miracle foundation routine that's going to just make your skin look flawless, because it's not possible. But I've been doing my makeup for a very long time and dealing with acne scars, and I've made all the mistakes. So I'm going to give you my everyday routine that I feel have made my skin look better. So let's get into the video.
First thing is skin prep. I'm cleaning my skin with a micellar water by Bioderma. Clean your face however you like. Next, I'm going to be using a hyaluronic acid hydrating spray and patting that into the skin. But usually I use some type of hydrating serum or a gel moisturizer, anything that is super light and doesn't leave a film on the skin. And then I would apply my foundation directly after that. But I ran out of that, so I'm going to be just using a hydrating spray today. I'm going to conceal first. I'm using ColourPop Pretty Fresh and mixing two shades. Starting with under my eyes using the Delium Tools brush. I will link all my brushes down below. This is not highlighting. If you have dark circles, you want to neutralize that first before highlighting, or they will look even darker. Use a concealer that is closest to your skin tone or even a little darker. I also like to conceal any other areas that need it, so I don't use too much foundation. I also forgot to mention, I don't like to use pore filling or putty primers. They sound ideal for pitted scars and large pores, but they are usually silicone based, and I hate the way makeup sits on top of silicone. I haven't noticed my scars looking any better or my makeup lasting any longer, so that's a no for me. For foundation, I'm using ColourPop No Filter and mixing two shades together. I'm applying it first with my fingers so I don't pick up too much product, and I will add more thin layers if needed. I like to use a stippling brush. Stippling brushes are great for indents in the skin and large pores, and I have both. It helps to push the makeup into the skin and fill it in those areas. I suggest not to buff in the product too much, especially if you have dry skin. That could exfoliate your skin. I like to really focus on my areas that I have the worst scarring, which is both of my cheeks, by stippling the product in. You want to use a matte or semi-matte foundation. If you have dry skin, just make sure you are really hydrating your skin in the prep step. Stay away from foundation that is dewy, because that will reflect light and bring more attention to your problem areas. That goes for shimmers and glitters as well. And now I'll be going in with a light shade concealer and dabbing it into my scars so they don't appear so dark. And again, using a matte or semi-matte concealer. I'm gonna go over everything with a flat top kabuki to make sure everything is blended nicely. Sometimes the stippling brush can leave little streaks. Now using that same light shade concealer, I'm going to highlight, starting in the inner corners, and then I'll blend it out. I'm going to set that with the RCMA No Color Powder. I like to use this under my eye area. Now going in with Milk Cosmetics Setting Powder, applying a light layer over my face. Now this next step is very important. I use a foundation powder with coverage in the areas of my acne scars. When I only use a translucent powder on my scars and then apply my bronzer or blush, my scars always look super dark and more noticeable. So I started dabbing on some foundation powder in those areas before my bronzer, and I noticed a difference. Not a huge difference, but a difference nonetheless, and I will take anything that makes my skin appear a little better. Going in with bronzer and an angled blush brush, make sure you dab in the product. Do not swipe, especially with too much pressure, or it will rub your makeup off and make the scarring look worse. Then I'm going in with my blush by Inglot, and I'm going to do the same technique I did with my bronzer and just dab in the product. If I do swipe, it's very gentle. I'm not putting too much pressure. And now I'm going to finish with an under eye brightening powder by Besame Cosmetics. And that's it. Thanks for watching. If you want to see more videos, please consider subscribing to my channel. See you next time.